Eh sì, noi raccontiamo tante belle storie. Una di queste belle storie è quella di George Marcello. L'abbiamo visto circa in marzo. Ha voluto dare un challenge così a quello che è la donazione degli organi. Ha voluto percorrere 2000 chilometri a piedi per dare un segno e dimostrare appunto che questo grande donare gli organi è qualcosa di veramente fantastico, soprattutto per le persone bisognose, anche perché lui è stato uno di questi che appunto ha ricevuto un organo. E io adesso volevo un attimo subito passare la parola a Donina, perché Giorgio è qui con noi, un po' dimagrito, ma c'è, è qui con noi, è ritornato dopo 2000 chilometri.
Well, while we were all enjoying our summers, George was walking 2000 kilometers across Ontario. So you're a real hero, George. Congratulations. How do you feel?
Well, I'm not tired.
George, just to set you up, you received a liver transplant about 2.5 years ago now, and you're in fine shape, and you wanted to give back a little bit to the community. In Canada, you're not allowed to connect with the donor family, nor vice versa, correct?
Well, as far as connect, the only means of communication is through a screen letter. So what I'm going to try and introduce is something called mutual consent. I found that there was many donor families that had a strong desire to meet the recipient, and many recipients such as myself that had a strong desire to meet the family. So what I'm trying to introduce is to have that option available so that at some point in time, if both desires are mutual, then there should be an option available.
And that's similar to the adoption
exactly.
rules, mutual consent.
Exactly.
That's great.
So and that's... it also would play an incentive, to people to donate more organs and their families to donate the organs, because if they know that maybe there might be at some point that they'll be able to probably possibly meet the recipient and have a feeling of continuance from their loved ones.
And that's how it is in the States, correct?
Some states.
Okay, yes. What about the National Registry? Now, you were walking 2,000 kilometers across Ontario, but apparently you had time for other stuff. What about the National Registry?
Well, that's another thing that I was trying to promote along the way.
I'm a very busy man this summer. I'm ashamed of myself. I didn't do very much.
you did a lot. You did what you had to do this summer. This National Registry, I think it's been long overdue, and we're really a country that's behind in that scene. Many countries do have it, and they're experiencing a lot of success in organ donations. And what that would entail would be that at present, we have this scenario where even though you do sign your donor card, most of the time that wish is getting vetoed. And the reason why is because the hospital officials have to approach the family for the final decision. And what a time to approach the family at a time of tragedy.
I understand that you have a meeting with Premier Harris in November.
Yes, it's presently getting scheduled. We're in the process of scheduling it.
And you're going national too. You're going to do something at the House of Commons. And
yes.
You're inviting the House of Commons and the province to get behind your project.
Yes, absolutely. We're definitely going to need their support on this. And this will be part of our scenario when I'm doing the walk across Canada in May of 2000. I'm not finished yet with this.
Well, George, can I just blow your horn a little bit? But in Windsor on Friday, September 17th, the day was called officially George Marcello Day by the mayor.
Yes.
So this is a big deal. You've gotten a lot of attention. You've certainly achieved your goal. You've achieved organ donation awareness throughout Ontario. So congratulations. You have lots of work yet to do.
So you're the example of a man who has had a liver transplant, and you're just as good as new, right?
Absolutely. I'm not the exception here. That's the other thing I wanted to point out. There's many, many recipients that are having similar healthy lives.
There's the arrival
of
George Mazzella at the Columbus Center.
Just a few days ago.
Yep. Yeah, we had Alma Fadani actually organized all that.
That's your route.
That happened later.
Yes.
Was it a beautiful summer? Is Ontario?
Ontario is the most beautiful province in the world.
And you were well received.
Yes, by every community. There's a lot of Italians in Ontario. I can't believe it.
Everywhere,
even Smith Falls. There was a guy that on the highway said, "Hey, what are you two paisans doing on the highway here?"
How many pairs of sneakers?
He wanted to give you a lift, I guess.
Well, he gave us $20, but he had to kiss my road manager.
How many pairs of sneakers did you go through?
Actually, two. Nike's been pretty good.
I chose. Before we end up with you, George, we want to introduce one of your partners, your road manager,
Joe
Camara.
Yeah.
Come on in, Joe.
He was there right from the beginning.
Joe has been with you right since June 26th. And Joe, you have a few words to say. Joe has Portuguese descent, correct?
That's right, I am. And I'd just like to say to those organ donor families, thank you. And for those people on the waiting list, keep the faith. Should be coming soon. And I would like to thank Cellular Depot, who have helped us out with a phone that was very necessary for our communications. And I'd like to say hi to my family for their support also.
Thank you, Joe. Congratulations. The job well done. Thank you, George. I'm sure we'll
see you
here again.
Oh,
I know you're going, you hope to go national with your national registry.
Yes.
And you'll keep us posted.
Absolutely. And
wonderful.
Thank you very much for all your support.
Bravo, veramente.
Glad to have you. Congratulations, Joe.
Laura Pausini. Adesso andiamo subito ad ascoltare con questa bellissima canzone la mia risposta. Laura Pausini.